Well, you know, this building, you can go as long as you want.
Yeah.
Oh, well, it's 8:45, but you can go as long as you want.
It's
not
like
it's
not like
it's
not
like it's
warm
up the century. Yeah, but it happens.
And you look like you got a good roof here.
Yes, it's a very good roof.
And I don't think we'll be here for Tuesday.
Well, actually, it's this one. He has what you're saying as far as like as a new writer, it's like, so you have an idea, you have your you know, your protagonist, your antagonist, and then a cast of characters, as you're saying, but what would be sort of like a good number of characters? 24 seems kind of out to me, but maybe 10. Maybe 10 is like, so say if they had a family.
Well,
they
you know what Abraham Lincoln said, someone asked him, because he was a very tall man, they said, how long should a man's legs be, eh? And he said, it should be long enough to reach the ground.
It really depends,
on
your book, but I can tell you, there's no number. What there is you look at the characters and what their jobs are, and then you try to figure out if you can combine them. Because if the person who you go down to play tennis with also turns out to be your rival's girlfriend, then you're still using the character to do more.
Mm-hmm.
So what you want to have is the least number of characters you can have to tell the story well.
Right.
Yeah, sometimes you want to have characters out there in a to give a feel. You know, I'm writing a story that takes place at a school. I have certain characters just to have a sense that there's other people out there because it feels more realistic if there's more than three people at the school.
Mm-hmm.
But those type of characters you don't want to have come on stage in more than maybe a brief reference or something like that. So I won't count characters whose job the reader can tell is merely that's the captain of the football team. He doesn't need to be a character, he just needs to be known that such a person exists. When you're talking about characters who are actually going to interact with the story, I think the key is to try to say, well, you know, how small a number can I make? Now, that number might be huge, but you would want to make it as small as you can make it and make the story make sense.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can always add, you know, you can always add someone else if you need it. But anytime you have this thing and this thing, and you can make the same character do that, those two things, the story gets a little more vibrant, comes alive a little more.
Think of it as like if you were actually setting it on a stage and you had to hire those actors and you had to pay them scale, like scale. Well, if you had to pay the guy $15 an hour every moment he was on the stage, you would think of a way to combine the characters just so that the budget wouldn't bust.
You'd also eliminate children and animals.
You would eliminate animals, you could combine people as much as you could. You would calculate all the crowd scenes carefully to get the minimum number to get the crowd effect that you would like, and then you would force everybody to double. So in the next scene, they all get to be reporters at the jail, then they're the crowd scene, then the next,
well,
the next
but,
scene.
But that sort of combination and that sort of looking for the minimal number is exactly the way we avoid cookie-cutter women, cookie-cutter men.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to have somebody who is the bad guy's girlfriend, I think, but you also need somebody to drive the bus. All of a sudden this woman can be driving the bus, even though we don't see that many women driving, but, and it gives you a way of breaking out of some of those other limitations and stereotypes as you're pairing down.
The moment you're a bus driving mole, you're
really and all of these things are, you know, they're meant to be fixed on the rewrite. I think that if you look at the various drafts of The Lord of the Rings that have been published by Christopher Tolkien, I think, or in the original draft, poor Elrond had several children, and Tolkien began to winnow them out. He said, well, you know, the sons, the boys, they don't really do very much. Maybe we only need two. At the moment,
one have a lot of characters.
He's got two of them in there. You can't differentiate them. They never say anything. And the case could be made they should have been one or even zero. And if you look at the movie, that really, you really got them down there. You know, it's. He didn't actually, you know, writers don't actually have to pay these people. That's why you can get away with a great deal, but you could think about that.
So if you do give your characters dogs or small children, you better make sure that they are accounted for any time that, you know, their characters need to go on adventures, you know. Because dogs gotta pee, and little kids gotta, whatever it is, little kids do.
That is so true. The story I'm writing has children at a magic school, and everybody has a familiar. And I'm constantly forgetting and having to go back and figure out Where are they feeding the familiars? Are they in the dining room? What do they have in the rooms to keep them? And I have to do a familiar rewrite where go ahead and put the dog back in, have the bird fly by, because it's based on something that was done separately that I've been turning into a story. There were no familiars in the original, so it's been a real struggle to keep track of them. And
that's what Excel spreadsheets are for. And then, of course, post-it notes. You could stick a post-it note. Where is the familiar?
But the other side of it is that every time I do a familiar rewrite, I think the story comes out a lot better, because by the time I sit down to think, what is the dining hall like in a place where everybody has a familiar, and which animals get to go in there and which don't, which ones get fed the menagerie. I mean, he adds that kind of particularness that makes it stand out as being different from the 1,600 other magic girls that are out there.
It's surreal. I mean, the characters are now caretakers in addition to whatever adventures that they have to do. They're also
animal